Hello everyone! Welcome to another episode of our Farming RPG tutorial series. As we get closer to implementing more NPC features, we should also improve on the user experience along the way. I thought that it would be more useful to the player for there to be a prompt indicating if you can interact with the object. So I made some assets for the UI. And popped it into Unity. We already had a script that looked at the camera. Since we'll have more UI elements in the world space that will look at the camera, I made a new script, World UI, for all future scripts to inherit from. To not constantly spawn a new bubble every time the player looks at an interactable object, I made it so that only one instance of it, which is handled by the UI manager, gets triggered, set active when the player hovers on the object. It seems that more adjustments are needed, so I added some offset. And made it so that each object can change the offset from which the interactable message appears. The default message should be something general like interact, and I made it so that we can alter the message when we need it to do something more specific. After that, I noticed that the character walking animation was a little bugged, so I fixed it. And we got a bug that was brought up to us by a viewer. When you go to sleep immediately after starting a new game, it fails to save and a null reference exception pops up. So we got right onto the problem and added checks for null values so that this would not happen. And generally it is good practice in your code to check for these things. And then I looked at all the text in our project. I realized that now Unity is moving over to Text Mesh Pro. And it looks like we can do a lot more things using Text Mesh Pro rather than with the standard Unity text, which is now called Legacy Text, apparently. So I thought that I would switch everything to Text Mesh Pro. But then it would be very tedious because we have tons of UI elements in the game. So I went onto the Unity forums and found a handy little script to do all these things for me. Unfortunately, the script doesn't change the code, so I had to go onto every script that mentions text and switch it over to Text Mesh Pro and reassign everything. So that took me a while. And yeah, that's enough detours, let's get to the meat of this part, calendars. This is what we need as we get ready to implement festivals and events for NPCs and relationship system. So I created the calendar panel with its entries spanning 6x7. Each calendar entry will have a date value and an image to mark any special events. After I picked out the colors of the color palette it will have, it was time to get to work on the script. First, we make the script for the individual calendar entry, which will store basic information of the day that it is representing. It will have four states: the weekday, Saturday, Sunday, and empty. Each of these states will have a different color, with the empty being completely transparent. It will also keep track of the description to elaborate further when the player hovers upon each entry. But we won't be doing that today, it's for another time. But we are going to keep track of the description so that we can implement that in future. And now on to rendering everything and putting everything together. So I created a new class, Calendar UI Listing, and made the function to render the calendar. It will consist of three main functions: rendering the calendar, moving to the next season, moving to the previous season. And the logic looks like this. The start of every season might be a different day of the week. Of course, spring first of the start is a Sunday. But it is not true of summer first. It's going to be another day. So we get the first day of the season that we want to render, and see what day of the week that it falls on. In our calendar, we want to start rendering our Sundays first. The problem is, we have set our enum values to have our Sunday to be of index 1. So we need to make a few minor adjustments. We have to add 6 to the value and apply the modulo operator to it, so that the day value would start from Sunday to Saturday. Now, there won't be any entries before the first day of the season, so we will iterate through each calendar entry, marking all of them before the start of the season as empty. Now we can create our main loop, starting from the first day to the last day of the season, which will feed each day with the necessary data. On normal days, all we need to do is give it the date value and a day of the week. But there will be days that are special, and we will add festivals and special anniversaries in the future. But the special days that we have now are birthdays. Hence, we will create a function that will check for them. In relationship stats, I made a function that will return the birthday of the NPC according to the timestamp provided. And we add that to the main loop. And now, at the end of it, don't forget that there might be leftover days that carry over to the next season. So we add one more loop that will iterate through the remaining days and mark them as empty. And there we have our calendar. Next is to have it open the screen when our player interacts with the calendar in his house. So we added a calendar to the player's house and created a class to open the calendar accordingly. And there we have it, a fully functioning calendar. And that's it for this part. I hope you enjoyed it, and we will see you next time.